Hello everyone, my name is Hilkin Wiersma and welcome by EA's Art Channel. Today I'd like to talk about the painting I recently finished, and it's obviously a pastel painting. I used my pen pastels, my pastel pencils and my pastel sticks. It's quite a large piece, as you can see, and there's a lot going on, so I have a lot of details painted in, and I will talk about all of them as much as I can in this tutorial. But first, we do that, I'd like to explain a little bit about the concept of this painting. It came across while I was driving in my car, and I saw a crow sitting on a... actually, it was a black crow, and he was sitting on a sunflower, and probably a dead sunflower, but... then I saw this idea, this concept of a... basically it's inspired by balance. And to be honest, with yin yang, and I think basically everything is about balance in our lives. And for example, in weight, and also in friendships, there has to be always a sort of balance. And that is what triggered me, and I did try to show that balance in nature, in nature's form, because the yin-yang symbol is very even. You have a black portion and a white portion, and they are all even. And I don't think in nature the balance has to be as perfect, and of course I love the symbol, don't get me wrong, but I think you can find the balance also in nature. It's normal to have things that are in balance. And it's hard to describe, as you may already notice, for me at least. But yeah, I think I try to show you that feel of balance with a black crow, a white crow, but also a sunflower who is in flower and a dead sunflower. And I think there is a nice symbol going on. So now you know a little bit more about why I made this painting. And obviously I did use some reference photos, but I did make my own concept on within Photoshop. And I have a tutorial on my channel if you want to know more about it, how I make a rough sketch, basically a sketch in Photoshop, before I start painting, because I have to, personally I need some general lines to know where things should go, and I also, Photoshop gives me a nice idea if the concept as I had it in my head is a nice fitting for the painting, because many times I have to make some adjustments. Like in this one, I thought it would be nice to do that a symbol of a yin yang here in the middle of the painting, and make it maybe black and white, transparent, so the clouds would show up. But I thought that would be too busy, too distracting of the things I have going on here. And that is the main subject. I wanted to show that nature has also something in balance. And that's basically what I was thinking, and while I wanted to make this this painting. So that is a little bit explanation why and how I came up with this idea. So now it's time for the extra tutorial, and I will discuss the techniques that I used to make this painting. What I did forget to mention is that this piece is called Through Colors. And that's inspired by that once you see a balance, you see a balance all around you more and more and more. And it's just like a painting and drawing. When you're starting out, you maybe see a few colors, but the more you practice, the more colors you will see. So that's why I call this one True Colors. It's like when you are open your eyes, you are going to see the true colors. So that said and done, I was already started with the background, as you can see, and therefore I used my pen pastels, and I'm using some sponges to apply this pastel, and also I use the applicators, who are also came with the full set, and I like both of them, and I use the sponges most of the times for the big areas, and I like to use the applicators, who are a little bit smaller for those details. And for the clouds, for example, I did use most of the times those applicators, and because you can also move them a little bit and make by that movement you make some texture, and in this case I need some texture for the clouds. And also I came through with my pastel sticks, and with those I can make a little bit harder sharper edges where needed. And also I had a few colors who are would well fitting in with this artwork, so therefore I like to use also the sticks, and they go very well with the pens. So yeah, that's why you see me switching between the both. And now I'm using also an applicator who came with the full set, and it looks like a makeup brush kind of thing, but it works very well if you have not much pigment on the paper, but you like to smudge that out a little bit. If I use my finger, and to be clear, I use the Clairefontaine Pastel matte paper, and but when I try to smudge pastel with my fingers, and I don't have that many of that much pastel on my paper yet, it's kind of hard. But with that yeah, makeup brush kind of thing you saw with well, that comes with the full set, it's way easier. And I didn't know that, but just by sort of accident I experienced it with this piece, so therefore I use it quite more often than I normally do, because I have a lot more effects with that one earlier on. So therefore I like to use it, and especially for clouds, because they are kind of soft, and I like to smear to soft out quite a lot and smear that pastel around, because then I avoid those harsh lines. And yeah, with this applicator, it was very, very handy. And I will have it listed below if you want to check it out, so you more know what which applicator I'm talking about. But it's a very, very handy tool. And yeah, smearing a pastel around. I don't know if that's a word, but I mean move that pastel around the paper. And like you see, I'm just trying to build up as usual. I try to use as many colors as I can, but obviously I use colors who are fitting for this painting. So don't use colors who don't make sense, but try to use as many colors that will work really well, very well together. Like for this sample, in this case, I like to use quite some dark red and purple to let that orange more shine and look more deeper than it may have looked when I when the background was very light colored. So that's something to practice and to try to figure out which colors are to work very well together. And also, therefore, is a very handy tool, if you ask me, and that is the color wheel. I have it always around me, and most of the colors now who are going very well together, I know, and so I don't have to check it that often. But I, once a while, of a few times when I'm working, I check that color wheel still, because it's a very handy tool. If you don't know what I'm talking about, please do a research, because there are a lot of tutorials about that color wheel and how to use it and that kind of thing. So, and now over to the crow. I was already starting, and I did notice, for me personally, normally I make birds a little bigger, because I like to put in all the details, of as many details as I can. For this piece, it's quite a big piece, but there were more subjects that I needed to paint in, so therefore the crows couldn't be as big as I'm used to. And that meant for me that I couldn't make those details as I'm used to. So therefore, I needed to remind myself not to focus too much on the detail, just the indication of feathers. Don't make them too nicely, basically, I'm trying to say, because if you're making them too realistic, or too much work out, too much detail in the feathers, it will not look right, because the crow is a little bit in a distant, it's a little bit not especially in a distant, but it's smaller because of the composition of this painting. So therefore it wouldn't make sense if I have all those teeny tiny little details drawn in, because normally you cannot see them
in a sort such a setting. So therefore, yeah, I was trying to work with that, and I noticed that I had to rework some areas because I had too much detail in. So that's a nice practice when you know are not used to it. If your subjects are smaller, they have less detail. And it makes sense, maybe, but if you don't used to it, it can be quite hard. Believe me, I had to do redo some parts, but that's okay. I've learned enough again, and that makes me happy. Therefore, I like to draw and paint as much as I can. So this was once again a nice lesson, and this one was a very big lesson because I couldn't find a white crow in the right position for this drawing. How I had it in my head, how I wanted to be shown in this painting. So therefore, I came up with the plan to search for a crow who was in the right position. And I found it, but it was a black crow. So therefore, I had to make it white myself. And I did that by using the black crow for all the details and for the shape and for the body and all that kind of stuff. And so that was a reference photo, and I had three reference photos from white crows, and those were basically my ones to pick my colors. I used those colors and I painted them on the black crow, on the shapes of the black crow, if that makes sense. So that was kind of hard because I didn't have a exact reference photo from this crow. But eventually I'm happy how it turned out, but I had to also redo some areas, and that's okay because it was a nice lesson. I had to work from a little bit more from my imagination than I normally do because I always have reference photos. In this case, like I said, I did kind of have a sort of reference photo, but it wasn't in the right colors. And when it was in the right colors, it wasn't. It didn't have the right shape. But I drew and painted quite a lot of birds, and especially when I was younger, so I know, I have a basic feel of how the feathers should go, how long they are, which positions are quite normal for a crow to sit in, and that kind of stuff. And basically the autonomy of the birds I kind of know, and I work with them in my regular work quite often. If you don't know, I'm working in a bird hospital, so I see them quite often, and that was very handy because it was a little bit easier for me to make these details make sense. If you never drawn or painting a crow before, I wouldn't suggest to start out the way I did this one. Just stick with a reference photo who is completely how you want or how you like to at least practice a few times, and then it will become a bit easier to work from your imagination a little bit more. But and that's is in general. In this case, I using the crow as a subject. But for example, houses. If you never draw a house before, try to use a reference photo. It's a lot easier because drawing and painting from imagination is very hard, and there are a lot of people who actually cannot do that. There are a few who can, and they have a lot of experience. That was the word, I'm sorry. Have a lot of experience, but if you don't, if you are a beginner, I don't suggest that. And talking about the details, in the background are a lot of sunflowers. It's a field filled with those beautiful flowers. But once again, about the detail, you may think there is a lot of detail going on, and basically it is, but it isn't as sharp if you would talk about a picture. You see the shape, so we do know that those are sunflowers, but the details are hard to see. Maybe you want to try it out and watch a photo where a lot of, for example, flowers are in the background. You know they are flowers, but you don't see the petals as much one by one than you would when it's up close, like the sunflower I'm working on now. I have to paint in those petals one by one, but in the background, those flowers are, like I said, we know they are flowers, but that's it. So I need to be quite exact with my shapes, give the indication of petals, and also the colors. So working with lights and darks are making the difference. And also the colors, but lights and darks are very important, especially in these cases where there is not a lot of detail you can paint in. But once again, I do work with quite some different colors to make it more richer, more giving more depth in my colors. But I don't work as much on the details. I'm quite rough, and it hits me always when I'm doing that. I think I'm too rough, I need more detail. But no, you don't need that much detail, because the main subjects and the flowers, this big flower is one of them, will stand out way more if you don't use much details for your background. And colors is okay, as you can see, because the for example, the sky has a lot of different colors there. Those are in the right place. They make sense. There's not a lot of detail, but there are clouds, so there's a lot going on with color-wise. Not much detail. That's a very big difference, and I hope I can explain it a little bit well, or at least well enough, so you understand what I'm talking about. But yeah, that was for me personally quite a difficult lesson to learn, because you when you are working on this painting, you don't have much to compare your background with. And by that I mean, if I had that flower in that big flower, sunflower, right from the start, it would be easier to make that background. But I don't do that because first of all, I like to rest with my hand on a paper. So that I would smudge the pastels around, which I don't want, obviously, at least in these cases. And also, it is very hard to work on different places in one painting, because I'm working on an easel and the dust is falling down the paper. So I'm working most of the times from above to beneath, and that works for me very well. So that those are a few things to watch when I'm painting with pastels. And therefore it sometimes it's just hard not to to make the background later than you maybe want to do. And here I'm working with the sponge applicator. Most of the times I have a little bit of color there, but I'm smudging out my pencil lines. You may have noticed that I used my pencils for the sunflowers who are in more in the field, but I have to smoothen out those lines once again because of the detail. They're making too much detail, they are too sharp, so therefore I have to soften them out. But those sunflowers who are a little closer up, as you can see now, those petals you can see a little bit more than the ones who are further away, but not as exactly as sharp as the main subject, because those are once again closer. And it may sound very easy, but it's very hard if you for me at least it was very hard when I started painting, and to understand where to work on the detail and where to and when to stop, when to leave it. But once again, the more you practice, the easier it will get. And this may be a little bit strange, but I don't know why I really like the dead sunflowers as well. The shapes, the colors are so beautiful. So I finally had a big excuse to paint one for this piece, but I don't know why. But I like them as well. And I know that some people are letting them dry and use them for decoration in the house, and I kind of get that. I don't have that, but I don't know why, but I like the colors and the shapes. And here I'm working a little bit on the last details. Most of the times I'm working on the highlights, and here and there I needed to adjust a little bit once again the details. I was a little bit too sharp, or I missed a few, that kind of stuff. But for this process I take quite some time. I'm really watching my painting and then readjust some areas, watching it again, watching it from a distance, coming back, and that is very for me at least very important, and it helps me to get in those last details to let it, for example, a little bit more pop, and to let it work with one another. So therefore I'm really taking the time for it. And this is the photo of the actual artwork. And I hope you like it. I'm really happy about it. It's for me, it was quite a challenge. There was a lot going on, a lot of detail, and also the white crow using a black crow as a reference and then making it white was quite a challenge. But I think I'm happy. I'm maybe here and there I could do a little bit better. But I think color wise, it's in shape. And yeah, I'm really happy how this turned out, and I hope you like it too.
So, yeah, maybe you noticed, but my husband is working on a book, and this one is, because I talked about it before, but this one is also going to be in that book. So, this is very great. I'm very happy with that. It's obviously, I see it as a compliment for my work. So, yeah, that's going to be fine. And maybe one day I can show it to you, or a few pages. I don't know. He's working on a book still, so I don't know when it will be finished. And maybe I can show something, some parts of it. But I will come back to that later on, when the book is finished. And of course, as usual, if you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. The next one will be also a painting, a surrealistic painting about horses. I'm not going to talk about it a lot. If you want to know more about it, I have some pictures posted on my Instagram. But yeah, I think it's fun to have it a little bit of a surprise, of course. So I will have that up in, I think, 2 weeks from now. And then I will make another portrait. So if you like the portraits that I make, I know a few people are at my channel for the portraits. There's another one coming up soon. So that will be in the near future. After that, I have no idea. Probably I'm not a surrealistic painting, but I, like I said, I have no idea. And I really want to work with my watercolors again, and also with my inktense. So probably I will mix some of those in with my next art piece. But we will see. For now, I have a lot to do. So those tutorials will first be up, and then we will see what I come up with then. For now, thank you for watching, and also, of course, for the new subscribers and all subscribers who were already here. Thank you very much hanging out with me on my channel. I see it as a compliment for my work, and like I said, or like I always say, if you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. For now, once again, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye-bye!